Okay, MacDroids, can we talk for a moment? The people are not very happy lately when it comes to the Asterix brand. You know, the comic hero the defense of the Roman Empire, led by Caesar, in the year 50 BC, together with a druid that can make magic potions to give him super strength, and his best friend that fell down into that potion, so he has unstoppable strength for eternity. You started out from the remake of the second game, XXL2, with nice upgrades, but the fans didn't really like it. You went to a self-made game with XXL3, and there you had a bunch of mixed feelings about that. So, how do you people fix that? Well, go back to where it all started and do it good this time. That has to be the mindset of the developers when it comes down to this game. If people really are going to complain about it, then we will show them how it has to be done, with a classic style and on top of it, extra mode to keep the people entertained. Then why was there no promotion about this game? There was only one simple text interview in a magazine, one simple trailer at GameStop with a German language, and later on you released it, the English version of it, 1 week before its official release, and it's only the base game that we can sell in the store. No limited editions or an exclusive stuff like what you did with the other two. Well, then it's up to me then to short it out once again to make a review about you guys. If nobody wants to do it, then I will do it, because I love Asterix and Obelix. And ladies and gentlemen, this is my review of Asterix and Obelix XXL Remastered. They wanted to be very clever when it comes to that. The game starts out like any other day in the village of the Gauls. Everyone is doing their daily task in a nice sunny day. But after a rainstorm, everything did change when the Roman Empire attacked. All over nowhere and took the village down. While Asterix, Obelix and Idefix were going on a hunt into the woods, finding some wild boars for dinner. The only one that can help them out in this time of need is a Roman spy. Why is a spy helping them and not Caesar? Because there was no need for such a spy anymore after they took down the last village, and he felt betrayed by it, so he wants to get his revenge back at Caesar and show them there's still need for him more. The spy told where one of his friends is held behind bars, and he will help us such as gathering information and opening doors further down the line into the game. With low effort, we saved our droid Gedefix. He explains that the Roman Empire has a new type of weapon in their hands and has captured all of our friends and spread them over the whole Roman Empire. So it is up to Asterix, Obelix and Idefix to save all of our friends from the village and find out what kind of a weapon Caesar has in his hands. I can say, I like the idea of it, what they wanted to go with it. Starting out where Caesar has won, destroy the last village in his way to conquer the whole Europe continent and capture all of his friends and spread them all over the world of his own continent. In execution, well, not a big fan of it. Where were Asterix and Obelix where it all happened? Just hunting down into the woods. Well, this all happened off screen in the first couple of minutes. How did they get help where they need to find their friends? Just a spy that worked with Caesar. Oh, and let's throw a giant made out of stone map that every prisoner has, that can lead you to the next person where we need to go that is helped in prison. Just a reminder. Caesar did broke this map with his knees because he was so angry with it that it took him this long to defeat the last village of the Gauls. A map made out of stone, and every prisoner has it, and they have it without even Caesar looking at it. Even though he was the person that did destroy it, in front of their eyes. If they made small changes to it, I would say this would have been a fantastic story. The idea of the story is great, I'm just not a big fan of it, of the execution of it. Boy, where do I even begin with this? I normally start with the gameplay part of this game and go later down into the review about the graphics, how the game looks. But this is an exception of it, because their main selling point on selling this game to the main core audience was the graphics. Since they know that hardcore fanbase didn't stop complaining about it, how the older one looks better in comparison to the remake of XXL2 and XXL3 that they have made up from the ground up. Heck, they even call them out in their trailer what they have done.
Discover the retro mode. For those who are nostalgic for 50 BC. The purists, as we call them.
And now with that said, they are finally giving us both at the same time. With the press of a button, you can play this game with the old classic look back when it came out in 2003. Or with a new remastered look. And oh boy, this is so unpolished. I feel like they had a short amount of time for making this game in a new engine that they never worked with it, and make sure that you can play the old one and the new ones at the same time. And let's put on the graphics on the max settings while we roll with it. Sure, I know it is not an easy task to do that with an old graphics looks and compared to a new one, all together in one go. The amount of colors I see pop on contrast in the map while I'm playing on it, the remastered look was not a pleasant to watch. In one moment it is all bright, and in two steps forward, bam, it's all dark. Or flickering lights. Everybody loves flickering lights all of a sudden. Yes, in some places I can see what they were aiming for it and what they have done with a fantastic world of it and their models on their characters in their remastered look. Mind you, this all happened on the game launch when I was recording it all for you people for this review. Before they updated with a later down into the patch, not soon after a couple of days after the game released here on the Switch. Still the problem, if there is too much going on, it lags for a little bit, but I can let that slide since this is a Switch version of the copy. I hope. Does this mean that the older look is the fantastic superior version? Well, yes, but actually no. Sure, the older one does not have the best looking graphics once the game did came out in 2003. It kinda has a charm for me when you look at it in certain angles of the game. If there is one complaint about it what I have with the older graphics, it's about the size of its screen. Sure, I know, older screen has to play with smaller screen. But if you go to the merchant and you select the older graphics style, you can still play it with full screen. And I want to give that a shot. I really want to see the comparison in those two games. The rest of the older looks, just some tweaks and such to compare to the older game back on the PlayStation 2 and the GameCube that can only be found in Europe. Just happy we can switch it on the fly in a button if you want to play it in the old style or the new style. I played with both versions of it. Sometimes I had to go with the new one looks because the old one was kind of janky for me. And sometimes I did go with the old one because the new one was kind of janky for me. Just tweak it around with a new remastered look, make it a little bit better, just not so pop in color, so contrast, and maybe after this review there will be more updates down the line, so we don't see this problem anymore. I really hope so. Oh where shall I start with this? This remastered game has a lot of gameplay that we can talk about for better or worse. Astrid is well known in the comics for exploring to new places for his adventure and beating down the Romans on the side. So I'm happy to say this game has it all. We explore 5 different levels as a 3D platformer with puzzles on the side and a small collectathon if you really want to. Platforming is your 3D basic game what we have nowadays, a run ability and a double jump. Puzzles that we have are your basic kids game like puzzles, mainly focus around breaking crates, torch fire from point A to point B, pushing pulling stones, and as last, collecting the amount of stuff so that the spy can open the gate or door, whatever is in your way. It's all simple stuff for every platformer game, but what this game really stands out is the combat what we have in this game. You want to hit the switch? Then beat down the Roman first. You want to use this torch? Better beat down those Vikings for us. Oh, you want to use this weapon to destroy that wall? Yeah, we get it now. Beat down the amount of enemies to go further on in your adventure. It would have been okay if there were plenty of different enemies we can fight. What you get are your basic Roman soldiers, the Roman generals, stronger Roman soldiers, and sometimes in one level, a new type of unit for that specific level. Really hope you like the way you need to fight them. All what you need to do is punch every Roman as fast as you can till they go up into the sky. Will they be blocking? You better spam that attack button till they go into the air, or you can use them as a lasso against them. It does not mind what type of enemy you have to fight. You spam against them all until you have unlocked a combo move that you can buy from the merchant where you did collect all of those helmets in your adventure. Highly recommend you go first for the multiplier and then go for the helmets, because buying the combos are not cheap, let me say that. And if you have fun, spam one of those combos moves to get rid of the Romans faster. Sadly, you can only do it if the combo meter is full, and even then it can glitch out, so you have to wait till it's all empty to fill it up back again. Yes, there are glitches in the game. Speaking of bad things, you know what I really hate about this game? The amount of Romans you need to kill as easy as they can kill you if there are too many. And if you die, all the multipliers, all the shields, all the HP recovery that you have picked up are all gone until you reset the game from the last checkpoint. Who came up with that idea in the first place? Well, at least we can abuse that in our favor every time we reset the game. Then there are the gold lorens and the extra stuff they have made for this game. The gold lorens are just an extra thing to collect for a free skin, so if you are into that, then you will enjoy it whatever you need to do. As for the new stuff they added, there are 2 stuff for you. Time relic races and collecting coins while switching to the old and new graphics in between. They're all just extra stuff that you can do if you ever want to complete it for 100%. Something I don't do, or else we will be stuck here for a very long time with this game. Overall, the gameplay is just fine. I can feel the difference compared to other games that we had last year and the year before. Can I really be honest with you guys? I swear, everything was on default on the settings, and the only thing that I really liked was the sound effects of the game, most of the time. Will it be the funny screams of the Romans, breaking down the crates, collecting the helmets in silver or gold with a big multiplier on top of it, collecting gold lorens when you pick them up, or slapping down the boss and collecting their meat? Even though I'm very picky when it comes to the sound effects of it, it's a remastered look, one compared to the older ones. And etc on the soundtracks, they were all fantastic for me. No, the main reason why I'm so mixed about it is the soundtrack of the game. That's really weird, because I know this is one of the best soundtrack lists that the game has offered to me in the trilogy that we have so played so far. But for some reason, I really didn't like how it comes out of the game. I really hope it is just me with that problem, and that's really offsetting for me, because I know this game, like I said, has a fantastic soundtrack and I love to listen to it off the side. It is a real piece of art, and I do recommend listening to it on the side. I'm really a weird person sometimes. You have saved almost everyone that was held in prison. all there's left is to save the chief of the village from the hands of Caesar. And where would he possibly be? In Roman, of course. Their hometown. I hope you are prepared for it, because the Romans are. And oh boy, I hope you have your combos ready. Hope you like at the start of the map, starting out fighting over 1,000 Roman soldiers, followed up with more Roman soldiers, and more after that, and more that are stronger. Man, I know they were famous and beating down lots of Romans, but this is a little bit too much for me. Just very happy we had the tornado move to help us come along and defeat them all easily. If we didn't have that move unlocked before then, yeah, then I wish you all the good luck with that, defeating all those Romans in one go. With that said, we saved our village chief. The thief says his farewell before warning us that Caesar has one trick up his sleeve to defeat us once and for all. And his last line of defense is not one, but two machines that we have to fight, with the same HP threshold as any other machines that there was before any other levels. Defeating those two machines, Caesar finally surrenders, so we go back to the village, having a big feast like it was any normal day to them. Not very anticlimactic, if you say to me. The final boss is just the same as the rest what we did in every other level, only they can shoot more cannonballs at you. Was hoping for more something really big, because we are in Rome against Caesar. I want to see its full power of his army, something that he was hiding from us since the beginning, like a new type of machine. All what we got was a repeat of the rest of any other levels, only then with bigger numbers, fighting a lot of Romans and fighting a basic machine at the end. And now that the Rome Mastered game is finally done, we can talk about this game in my honest opinion. Everybody has their own opinions about it. For me, it's slap in the middle. I can see the potential in it, but then I can also see the hate about it. I like the idea we can switch around to the old classic look and the Rome Mastered one. Even though the Rome Mastered one was not the best looking game, I like the idea of the extra add-ons what they give it a shot at. But the extra add-ons are just getting in the way. I like the idea of its combat, back to the good old days where people really loved, yet it clearly shows this is the first one, so it is a little bit repetitive. I can clearly see why people love it, yet I can clearly see why people hate it. For me, it just slap in the middle. Do I recommend this game for everyone? Only for the hardcore fans that do know what they are in for, with the goods and the bad sides, and see their own opinions about it. For the new people that want to see after this review, or want to give the other ones a shot at, well, I do recommend to give the XXL collection a try, since it is coming out also this year where you can play this game, the second one where it came out 2 years ago, and the third one last year, for a cheaper price. I'll just say go for that. Yet it does mean we still miss one game, and I don't think that's going to get remastered soon, since it is a licensed game about a live-action movie. Maybe my next review on the list that I can add. And hello there everyone, welcome to the end credits of Asterix and Obelix XXL Remastered. I'm very happy you stick it all the way at the end. I want to thank the lovely artist once again for making this wonderful thumbnail for me. And of course, I want to thank you people all. If you want to see more content, just hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you once again for a new review, or for something else. Either way, we'll be going now. I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.